Welcome back to more about TMS FNC AppTools, a great new component pack from TMS. TMS FNC AppTools are at the core of all platforms. These components are designed to be core components, essential components in all of your future and existing applications, because they will take over tedious tasks that you need to do in each of your applications. They are designed to be multi-platform. That means you can use them to develop Windows, macOS, Linux, and Raspberry Pi applications, the latter using Lazarus. In another video, I talked about the app update feature. Today, we're going to have a look at form persistence and app lock. First, form persistence. There is absolutely zero implementation required to store the form position and its size into an INI file. You simply drop a TTMS FNC app form persist control on the form and set the desired file name. Obviously, you can also do the latter in code to have a dynamic file name. Here's the demo application shipping with a product. The control is on the form. The file name property is set to the application directory, and then there are no events being implemented, and also the source code is completely empty. Let's see how it works without writing a single line of code. The form is a square right now. Let's move it around and resize it to a wide rectangle, close the application, and restart the application. Position and size are restored. Zero lines of code and applicable for all the platforms just mentioned. App lock allows you to lock the application either by triggering the lock or after a certain amount of idle time has passed. Again, only a few steps are needed. Drop the component on the form. You may set a username and password to unlock the application. Also, you might set an idle interval before the lock happens automatically. And then you trigger the lock manually, or you enable idle locking, meaning after the system has been idle for a certain amount of time set in the idle interval, the application will lock automatically. Here's the example as a VCL Windows application. You can set a username and a password and lock the application manually. So let's set username to Holger, password to secret, lock the application. And now, if I click on the application again, I have to unlock it for the username Holger. I type the German word for secret. I won't be able to unlock it. I click again, and it works. The messages and the fonts of the dialogues that the component shows can be configured using properties. Be aware that after an unsuccessful password attempt, you have to wait a little bit before it is possible to unlock the application. Idle locking is also easily be done. Let's set the time to 5 seconds, enable the idle lock, and after we wait for 5 seconds, the application should lock. There, it's locked, and clicking on the taskbar, we can now unlock the application. Let's have a look at the source code. Manually locking the application is done calling the lock method. Of course, you can set the username and the password before you lock the application. It looks a little bit different when using the idle functionality. You don't call the lock method, instead you set the idle seconds amount, and you set the active on idle property to true. In order to disable the active on idle functionality, you have to manually set it to false. Just unlocking the application does not disable the feature, meaning if the time passes again, your application will lock again. That's the reason why you find this line here in the code where active on idle is set to false after the application unlocks. And that is the final thing I want to show you about this component. It has events. You can check for on idle if an incorrect password has been entered, if the application has just locked, if a query of unlock happens, so you can implement your own unlocking mechanism that's a little bit more sophisticated than just using username and password. And of course, you can trigger an action after the application unlocks again. And again, to verify the password, kind of the same area as Query Unlock, you can implement your own password verification. See more in the documentation about these features. So this concludes the initial look at TMS FNC AppTools. Let these components handle the tedious tasks that you have to do in all of your applications without having to write the same code over and over again.